Yeah, so I looked into the New York Red Bulls, which you could argue should be called the New Jersey Red Bulls. They are based in Harrison, New Jersey. Interesting tidbit about the Red Bulls. They've got the team captain, Sean Davis, is from Holmdel. They've got a bunch of players from Ridgefield, Flemington, Chatham. It is really a Jersey team, and they do a lot of work in and out and around the state of New Jersey with community service, working in Monroe and Newark and working with the Special Olympics. Just a great organization, and I think really does New Jersey proud. Joining me now, Marc de Grandpre, who is the New York Red Bulls general manager. What's going on, Marc? Good morning.
Good morning, Bill. Thanks for having me on.
Great to have you on. It really is... impressive what the Red Bulls have been accomplishing in New Jersey and for New Jersey. So tell me a little bit about the home opener coming up Sunday, 1 o'clock.
Thanks, Bill. Yeah, we're really excited. This is our 25th anniversary, and Sunday at 1 p.m. we're playing FC Cincinnati, our home opener for the season. And as you mentioned earlier, right, for everyone in New Jersey, I hope they come out and support their homegrown players. Our captain, Sean Davis, grew up in our system and is from Holmdel. Brian Wright, our starting striker, is from Flemington. Chris Lima from Ridgefield. And John Tolkien, a young prospect, 17 years old, who came through our system, just signed with us. He's from Chatham.
So as you mentioned, wait, it's truly a homegrown team. He's really, he's 17. Wow.
Yeah.
How'd you find him? How do you find a kid
like
that?
He was in our development system since he was a young boy, and he grew through our academy. And he's so talented, and we feel that he may have a chance to play with our first team. And he is, he's been training, he's been in preseason with us, and he's impressed everyone. So it's exciting to see this group of homegrown kids representing the state of New Jersey. So Sunday, come out and watch him on March 1st. You can get tickets at NewYorkRedBulls.com.
That's great. I'll tell you, Marc, I love the community involvement. Tell me what you're doing in Newark. What are these the mini pitches that you guys are doing?
So we've partnered with the Newark Public Schools, and over the next 5 years, we're going to build these mini pitches in school yards across Newark. And what we're doing here is not just dropping these mini pitches and branding them and saying thank you very much. We're providing after-school programming so the kids will learn how to play soccer, will learn about proper nutrition, will learn leadership skills. And the goal here is to give them an opportunity to learn the game, learn life skills in a safe environment around school. And we're proud of the partnership we have with Newark Public Schools.
How do you now? Do you rely mainly on volunteers with this, or is it teachers? I mean, who comes out to help with something like that?
So we have a group of youth development coaches that work across the state.
Yeah,
we touch about 45,000 kids a year. So we draw from our youth coaches to go and set up programming in these schools, and it's called the After School Soccer Program. And it's our own coaches. They're vetted. They're professionals.
That's
and they're providing a great environment for these kids to learn.
So let me ask you, let's just turn to the sport for a minute. You know, people talk about this, and it's hot and cold, right? You get a lot of people that they swear by soccer. This is great. We love it. And they're somewhat turned off by some of the other sports, you know, where you don't hear the politics in soccer. You hear about the things you're talking about. You hear about youth programs. You hear about community involvement. How much of an impact is soccer having on American sports spectators? Do you find it's growing and has been over the past couple of years?
Yes. Question: if you look over the last 5 years, the game has grown, right? Major League Soccer, the growth of the league across the U.S. has been exponential. We've seen expansion occur, right? We have Miami coming online, a new team. We have Nashville coming online this year. We're going to have Charlotte. We're going to have Sacramento eventually. You're seeing this growth, and St. Louis is going to come on board. And then attendance every year over year is growing.
Yeah.
Partnership and revenue for the league is growing.
That's great.
All the metrics are going in the right direction, but ultimately it comes down to all these kids engaging with the game and really embracing it. It has become the game of choice for these young kids in our country. And I think a generational shift is going to occur over the next 5 to 10 years, where you're going to see soccer really become at the forefront of professional sports in North America.
I think you might be right. Well, Marc, listen, congratulations and good luck this season. I will, of course, continue to make the pitch that it should be, if not just the New Jersey Red Bulls, at least like New York / New Jersey. We'd even take that. But I'll leave that to your good judgment.
I appreciate it. I absolutely appreciate that passion for New Jersey, and we absolutely have it also.
I know you do. Thank you, Marc. Great to talk to you. Good luck on Sunday.